Let's start at the beginning. Right about 1:39 this afternoon, we got a call at the sheriff's office that a vehicle had gone through the window that you see right behind me. Our units got here and immediately determined that there was only one person injured. Unfortunately, the one person that was injured was one of our detectives, Ezekiel Spence. He was injured originally back in 2019. He was actually here on an exercise bike rehabilitating that injury. He had hurt it in, on the job working as a detective chasing after a suspect who was running from him, and he was hit by a car then. If you fast forward from there, just about a year or so, year and a half, 2 years later, he was coming back to work, multiple injuries, fighting his way back. He's a former U.S. Marine, tough guy, very loved in the sheriff's office. And he's making another arrest, and the guy fought back, and he got his knee hit. Then a blunt object hit his knee. He was re-injured. So he's now actually rehabilitating that same knee, but after two injuries. And part of the rehabilitation is he's up here on an exercise bike rehabbing that knee when this driver hits the gas from what we see. It's just it's an accident. And she runs in through the plate glass window and makes contact and hits his knee again. And he was seriously injured and is being attended to at an area hospital.
Yeah, do you want to talk to me just about your visit to the hospital and sort of how Zeke's doing, what his demeanor's like? I'm sure he's in a lot of pain.
Well, the first thing I did, of course, was go to the hospital and check on my guy. He was in excruciating pain. They were reporting it as a 10 out of 10. He couldn't get the pain under control. He was hurt from his hip down to his toe. Contact was made with by that bumper actually hit his knee. So he was in intractable pain and working through it. He's a tough guy. This guy is not your everyday cop. He's a tough guy. And did not want to stay off from work, did not milk the system, as sometimes people will do. Came to work injured, played hard, played injured. And this is just one of those horrific tragedies. I mean, we're truly, the whole agency, as we've learned about it, we're stunned. I mean, of all the people, it's Zeke, and to have his knee crashed into three times, it's just inexplicable. It's just hard to even describe.
And I think the next question, to the extent that you can speak to it, is just what does this mean for Zeke's future? Could this be career-ending for him?
Yeah, as far as career-ending, I mean, I think it was a normal person. I would say this is probably game over. This is Zeke Spence, and Zeke Spence does not stay down.
Can you spell his first and last name?
It's Ezekiel Spence, S-P-E-N-C-E. But he goes by Zeke, Z-E-K-E.
And one more time, his rank?
He's a detective.
You can confirm the driver's a female?
The driver's a female. She's 59 years old, no evidence of alcohol. I mean, it's an accident.
Stayed here on scene, deputies were talking with her. Did she say what happened?
She's horrified. She's absolutely horrified. She stayed here on the scene. She did everything right. That's why you call them accidents. It's not something she meant to happen. There's no evidence of recklessness. It happens.
So as far as you know, at this point, she's not facing criminal charges?
No, she's not facing criminal charges. She did get a ticket for careless driving, which is not a criminal violation. It's a civil infraction. She'll really be able to pay the ticket. There's nothing more we can do to understand it. It's an accident. She hit the gas instead of the brake. It happens.
And there were two others in here, but I assume just mine.
There were other people. Nobody else needed hospital attention. It was direct contact with the detective.
Has he gone into surgery? Is he waiting to see if he needs surgery?
When I left the hospital, they were moving him back to X-ray.
Okay.
Trying to manage the pain and take a look and see what it was.
Okay.
Can you confirm it is non-life-threatening injuries?
Yeah, his injuries are non-life-threatening. They may be catastrophic for his knee, a tremendous setback in his rehabilitation, but it's not life-threatening.
Does he have three kids now?
Yeah, he has three children, and I think that Zeke would agree with me or approve of me saying that we really would ask for the the prayers and thoughts of the people of this county. He has spent a lifetime in the U.S. Marines and then years with the Sheriff's Office defending the public, and I think he would covet everybody's prayer.
When did he join the Sheriff's Office?
2014.
Did he go straight from the Marines to the Sheriff's Office?
He did, yeah.
You know, he's from Martin County originally?
Or? Yeah, he's a Martin County kid, raised here for sure. Serves his country, serves his community. And I think what's so sad to all of us is sometimes people get hurt and they use it as an excuse to milk the system. Not Zeke. Zeke was too tough for that, too much of a Marine. He wanted to come back.
He was really eager to get back to work.
Yeah, we couldn't keep him away. I mean, the problem with Zeke was, and I had to talk to him, Zeke, your leg's important, buddy. Don't push it. Come on, man. Give it some. Not Zeke. He didn't stay out of the fight. He just wanted to be in the fight.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Sheriff.
Yeah, good job.
Thank you.
He'll love